Welcome to show number 2 of Let Your Heart Sing, here on World Radio KHOE 90.5 FM in Fairfield, Iowa. I'm Sheila Moschen, and I'll be your host.
Today we'll be listening to music from musicians from Western Massachusetts, where I'm from, as well as songs from other musicians around the world. I'll play an interview with our special guest, Philip Tomlinson, who lives in Western Massachusetts, but used to live in Fairfield. We'll hear his original song called Arise and Shine. We'll begin today's show with a song that I wrote called Near Where the River Flows. It's a song about a big patch of jack-in-the-pulpits. And this song has an interesting story behind it. In 2009, the Connecticut River Watershed Council in Western Massachusetts had a songwriting contest. They were looking for songs about the Connecticut River. I remembered once finding a huge patch of jack-in-the-pulpits deep in the woods near the Connecticut River in Turner's Falls, Massachusetts. So I wrote a song explaining how to get to that jack patch. It was kind of a woodland treasure map. I invited my good friend Mary Newton Rose to sing the song with me. We didn't win the song contest, but the audience enjoyed our song, and we were invited to perform it at the Academy of Music in Northampton. That was an honor and a thrill. So let's hear the song, Near Where the River Flows.
A field of jacks is where we're heading, a secret garden that no one knows, except me and my friends who found it years ago. Near where the river flows, something special about that river, what it is we just don't know. Maybe it's full of plant hormones or spiked with miracle grow. Hiding way down deep inside the forest lies that field of plants I call jack. Hundreds of jack in the pulpits grow wild, waiting for us to come back. How I love those jack in the pulpits, my favorite plant since childhood. And I love the Connecticut River for nourishing this spot in the woods. How do I find this treasure?
Go to Turner's Falls in May. Walk along the canal towards the Conti AFL.
On one migratory way.
Yes, the canal is teeming with activity. Fish jump, swans swim by. Fuzzy little ducklings paddle close behind their mom. Bald eagles above soar high. Way before you get to the fish lab, take a ride at the end of the rail. The tunnel in the forest invites you to come in. Here starts the woodland trail. Follow the path towards the river.
Then take a look down below.
There you see a waterfall and fishermen fishing.
That's not where you want to go.
Instead, take a left to the grill works. Stay on the path till it ends. This is where my heart starts racing with excitement to see these old childhood friends. As a kid, I was thrilled to spot a pulpit. Finding one was so rare. I like to peek beneath their purple striped hood. Magic filled the air. How I love those jack-in-the-pulpits, tall and slender, regal and serene. And I love the Connecticut River for keeping them healthy and green. A rusty wreck guards this haven, this fertile and shady ground. Tranquility pervades this lush and sacred place. Songbirds sing all around. Once you spot that jack patch,
You may think there are no more,
but keep on trekking towards the river flowing by.
Giant jacks are preaching near the shore.
Wow, watch out for poison ivy.
It's everywhere and all around.
Probably protecting Mother Nature's ministers.
Praying for peace without a sound.
Thank you, Connecticut River, for the gifts you have bestowed
on me and my friends who take our yearly stroll
near where the river flows.
How I love those Jack in the pulpits, strong and majestic, they kindle my soul. And we love you, Connecticut River, for playing your life-giving role.
By the way, if anyone knows where there's a big patch of Jack in the Pulpit somewhere in Fairfield, please let me know. I'd love to see my old friends again. Now we'll hear a very pretty song sung by Susan Bassett, an accomplished musician in Western Massachusetts. I really love Susan's voice, and when I heard her sing this song at a church service, I knew I had to save it in my computer. I'm so glad I did, and now I'm so happy to share it with you. It's called Hear the Calling.
A new day is dawning, shining pure and new. The morning sun's reflecting in the early morning dew. It's a moment filled with promise and the trilling of the lark. It's time to hear the calling of the joy within our hearts. Ever flowing onward is the river to the sea. The evergreen is reaching towards the sun so faithfully. It's a moment filled with knowing, and our questioning departs. It's time to hear the calling of the trust within our hearts. And our spirits can't be broken, no matter how the world can seem. We gotta hang on to our love now. We gotta hang on to our dreams. Our hands will join together. Fear will be undone. We will recognize each other before this day is done. For the song is set in motion, and the words have all been sung. It's time to hear the calling of the love that makes us one. For the song is set in motion, and the words have all been sung. It's time to hear the calling of the love that makes us one.
Wasn't that simply beautiful? Now let's chat with my friend Philip Tomlinson. Many of you may remember Phil. He was in the MUM biology department from 1974 to 1983. Phil is a singer-songwriter and an author who recently wrote a book called Craving the Creator. It's available at Amazon.com. Say hi to your friends in Fairfield, Phil.
Hi, everyone. And thank you for having me on your show, Sheila. Yes, many of my friends in Fairfield may remember me, not only for teaching biology and the science of creative intelligence, but also for playing summertime on my saxophone. I became a member of the Prussia program in 1983 and earned an MBA and a PhD in physiology and molecular and cell biology from Marsh University of Management. In 1997, I needed to address a medical issue and wound up in Western Massachusetts, where you and I, Sheila, enjoyed teaching the Transcendental Meditation Program and conducting residence courses together.
And we had a great time writing and singing songs together. So, Phil, tell us about your musical background.
Well, when I was in fifth grade, my mother and one of my teachers were concerned that I was too much of a bookworm. They encouraged me to take music lessons. I played the clarinet in my high school marching band, and later played my clarinet and tenor saxophone in a local combo called the Starlighters.
That sounds like it was a lot of fun.
Sure was.
Can you tell us how you came to write the song that we're going to hear today called Arise and Shine?
No, I think this song came to me like most of my songs and poems do, when I least expected it, probably in the early hours of the morning. When I feel a song coming on, I first become dimly aware of a melody in my head. When the melody becomes clear, I quickly go to my computer and make a rough recording. The words come later.
So now here's the first song on Philip's CD called Arise and Shine.
Arise and shine, the dawn has broken. The morning sun illumines the sky. Go deep within with thought unspoken, to heart of fire and inner eye. Roam the fields, swim the oceans, face the wind, spread your wings and learn to fly. Expand the mind, release all notions, see the world from way up high. Escape the noise, the din, the shrillness. Your life won't ever be the same. Be still and feel the inner silence. A peaceful lake, a steady flame. Roam the fields, swim the oceans. Face the wind, spread your wings and learn to fly. Expand the mind, release all notions. See the world from way up high. Fully awake, alive with wonder. The light inside shines like the sun. No more disease, distress, or blunder. When life is bliss and all is one. Roam the fields, swim the oceans. Face the wind, spread your wings and learn to fly. Expand the mind, release all notions. See the world from way up high.
You've just heard Philip Tomlinson singing his song, Arise and Shine. I like that deep voice. Thank you for joining us, Philip.
It's been a pleasure, Sheila. Thank you for having me on your show.
It's certainly been our joy. Now, as a contrast to Philip's low voice, I thought it would be nice to hear a lovely female voice. Helen Scarff sings her light and lively song called Enjoy the Rose.
Happiness is our birthright. Happiness is our birthright. Why settle for anything less right when happiness is our birthright? The joy is in the rose. The joy is in the rose. Why waste time on the thorn? Enjoy the rose. Let's count up all our blessings. Let's count up all our blessings. Why dwell upon misgivings? It's much more fun to count our blessings. The joy is in the rose. The joy is in the rose. Why waste time on the thorn? Enjoy the rose. Let's smile on the good in each other. Let's smile on the good in each other. Embrace those tiny blunders. Enjoy the great big good in each other. The joy is in the rose. The joy is in the rose. Why waste time on the thorn? Enjoy the rose. beautiful roses, rainbow-colored roses, lovely fragrant roses. The joy is in the rose, the joy is in the rose. Enjoy the rose, enjoy the rose.
Now we'll hear Rick Stanley's All Possibilities.
I want to free all possibilities. Everything you thought that you could never be is now a possibility. And everything you thought that you could never see is now a possibility. I want to give all possibilities. Sail on down into the silent sea until you meet infinity. You can have anything you want at Rifton Parra's restaurant.
Let's hear a couple of poems by my guest, Philip Tomlinson.
Notes to Self. I like to sing like a bird likes to tweet. Give me a beat and I'll dance down the street. Melody, harmony, chorus, or band, whatever's at hand, improv or planned. When I haven't a song in my throat or my head, I have a song in my heart instead. To life. To enter time and laugh with glee. To walk the path of humanity. To have a body and still be free. To plant a seed and grow a tree. To watch a bee to taste a pea, to count to three, to bend a knee, to ride the waves and be the sea, to seek the truth and wisdom see, to enjoy the bliss with heaven's key, to be with friends and still be me, to know the peace of samadhi. What gifts life gives. Don't you agree?
Thank you, Philip. Now let's enjoy two songs by my friends Pat and Tex LaMountain. The first song is called Tractor State of Mind. The second song is called Summer Rain.
In the summertime, we'd pack the car, head up north to my uncle's farm. It was time to get away. My folks grew up as country kids, cows and corn and chicken and pigs. They loved to be there when they cut the hay. We'd meet the cousins in the yard, we'd all run down to the barn, then to the wagons in the fields. Well, we'd climb up and ride along, just barely hanging on. Maybe a little risky, we'd all be hot and dusty, but we're not worried, we're all doing fine. I just slipped into a tractor state of mind. It's time to stop the world. It's time to stop the world. Well, let's hurry up and get nowhere, like the tortoise and the hare. We're out chasing diamonds and pearls. And it's time to stop the world. Drive, loving it all, just being alive. Maybe one of those lazy August days. Well, we could be headed for the beach, maybe out to pick some peaches, to your favorite getaway. Well, what's that I see up ahead? Brake lights are turning red. Biggest load of hay I've ever seen. Well, there's not a thing that we can do to pass this sky and get on through. UPS and pickup trucks, they're barely moving, we're all stuck. What's there to do when you're caught behind? Well, a John Deere guy in a tractor state of mind. It's time to stop the world. It's time to stop. Well, let's hurry up and get nowhere, like the tortoise and the hare. We're out chasing diamonds and pearls, and it's time to stop the world. It's time to stop the world. It's time to stop the world. Well, for each of us, I guess there are some times we'd like to leave this old world behind and shift into a tractor state of mind.
Lock the door.
Thank you, Pat and Tex. And thank you, listeners, for joining us today for Let Your Heart Sing here on World Radio, KHOE 90.5 FM in Fairfield, Iowa. I'd like to offer a special thanks to our guest, Philip Tomlinson. Have a wonderful day.
Near the village, the peaceful village, the lion sleeps tonight. Near the village, the peaceful village, the lion sleeps tonight.
Oh, we mow away.